So, what's your name?
Ritvik.
Ritvik. And how old are you?
10.
10. And what's your rating?
1379.
1379. Okay. You need to speak a little louder, yeah? So, you're white or black?
I was white.
You're white. Let's look at your game. E4.
C5.
C5.
C3.
Knight F6. You like the Sicilian
Alepin
very much. Knight D5.
My coach taught me that.
Okay, who's your coach?
Rakesh Kulkarni, sir.
Oh, nice, Rakesh. He's my very good friend. Knight F3.
E6.
E6.
C24.
CD. D6.
Yeah, here I don't think I should have played Bishop B, sir. Bc4.
Why not? So one of the main moves, right?
I didn't that because after e6, I think instead of d6, knight c6, then bc4 is the line. Because after I tried to do the same thing with bishop c4, but...
What should you have played instead of
I that? Think knight c3.
But if I then
take and pawn into...
Pawn into and then knight c6.
Then I think we're converting into the main line. No. Yeah, bishop c4.
Then take.
Then. Okay, my castle is gone.
Oh, you might be in big trouble.
Yeah, okay. I think.
Alright, let's look at the game because I don't think bishop c4 is a bad move. Knight to b6. Bishop d3.
d5.
DE. Ah, you took with the pawn. Can you not take with the knight?
No, I've learned the lines where you play queen e2, pawn into e5. That.
Right. But can you not take...
I think knight into is a better move. Yeah. Because so, after d5, this d5 square was very weak and he exploited it.
So what was your reasoning for taking with the pawn?
No, I didn't want to keep it isolated. The line that... my Rakesh has taught me is, can you go back?
Yeah.
Go back. After CD4.
Yeah.
So knight C6. Bishop C4. Then D6. Castle.
Okay.
Castle. Then bishop e7, queen e2, then black castles, knight c3, knight into c3, b into c3, d into e5, d into e5.
This is the line he has taught you?
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, so taught me some other lines, but this is the main one.
Okay. Let's go back. There are so many options in chess that you cannot solve everything before the game. So you have to play during the game as well. So after d into e5, queen d1.
Bishop.
You took with the bishop.
Yes.
So overall it seems like black got a good opening position because...
Yeah, I think... Yes.
Knight c6, castles, bishop e7. Seven. But white should not be worse, right? Because he's... And now you played bishop b3 back.
Yes. Because I do not want him to get the d5 square.
So why not just develop your knight?
No, I thought he will just play knight c4 and put pressure on the e5 pawn. That's what I did not want.
But can you not just play rook e1 now?
Rook e1. Bishop b4.
Okay, so you're putting a lot of pressure on me, but let's say I just now push your knight back.
I can play bishop in a c3.
Okay, I take.
Knight b6 and then I felt my structure is not good.
But what about your bishop coming out to a3? What do you think about this position? Black is better?
I felt like that.
Why?
Because of the isolated pawn.
C3 pawn. The voice you can hear here is Ritvik's little sister. What's her name?
Trisha.
Okay. Trisha says c3 is isolated.
Even
you also think so? I mean, you know that c3 is isolated, but do you think that is the reason for black to be better here?
But black can't castle.
Yeah,
black can't castle. So
bishop is also
blocked. Maybe it's... But he can play bishop d7.
I personally think that this position should be better for white, because this bishop on a3 is very strong. It just cuts across the position. So
I was feeling like black would have threats like knight d7, knight d5.
Yeah, okay. Got it. Let's try to see. That's why you played bishop to b3 here.
Yes.
And
like this knight cannot come forward.
Yeah.
Without letting the bishop take it.
And then after bishop b3 castles.
Castle.
You went knight c3. Now you develop. That's good. Knight to d7. So he's attacking your pawn here.
Rook
e1. Rook e1 looks good. Knight c5. Yeah, bishop f4 also is not so bad. Just get your bishop here.
I think that's better.
I felt like my bishop should be on e3 when he cannot take. Then it'll be on an open diagonal.
But there are 2 points here. For example, if you look, there are 2 open files in the position. And you would like your rooks to be on these squares.
Yes.
So if you put your rook on e1, then you can't put them on these squares. And the bishop is a bit passive on f4. But it's a choice you have to make. Sometimes, do you want your rook to be active or your bishop?
It has to be the rook.
Yeah, so maybe bishop f4, as Trisha suggests, could be a better move. Why don't you just sit a little behind, yeah, like this, yeah, okay. So, bishop b3 castle, knight c3, knight d7, rook e1. I don't think it's a bad move at all. Knight c5, bishop c4. a6. And now knight e4. Why did you play knight e4?
I'm feeling like his knight at c5 is very good. And if I exchange both my knights for his knights, he can't exploit the d5 square.
You want to exchange both the knights?
Yeah, because so he cannot exploit the d5 square.
Do you know this rule in chess? It says the side with more space should exchange all the pieces.
No.
Which rule do you know?
I know, like, if you have less space, just try to exchange.
Yeah,
pieces,
of course, I was saying that. I was just trying to fool you. So, the side with less space should exchange pieces, right? So, which side has less space here?
He, I guess.
So, if he has less space, why are you going and asking him to exchange?
I was thinking, like, he can play knight b4, knight d5, and get a c5 knight, like, knight d7, knight b6, knight d5.
Yeah, sure. But if you take here, and then b5, and he gets his bishop to b7, you might go back here, and then bishop b7. I think black has solved all his problems of space, of development. Rooks are coming to d8 and c8, right?
Yes.
I think suddenly, your one move, I think knight e4, helped him solve all his problems. So knight e4 I don't like, but he didn't take. He played b5, which also looks okay. That's not a bad move.
Bishop f1.
Bishop f1.
And this is like the only move.
Yeah, this is fine. I think black is playing well. What's his name? Trish Karthik.
Karthik.
Ah, yeah.
But shouldn't he have played bishop b3?
Now?
Knight into b3, and my pawn would be very weak.
No, then a into b3, the rook has an open file on
a. Yes, but the thing is, this bishop, I think, was very important, because after something like bishop b7, maybe black is okay. This rook is on open file, but not so easy to... Yeah. No, your point is not so bad. I mean, like, you have this open file, and if you can get your knight somewhere to d6 at some point, or say to c5, you might start putting pressure already. Interesting, yeah. So your suggestions are not at all bad. Bishop f1, rook d8 was played.
Knight into c5.
Knight into c5, bishop into c5.
No, I feel I have less space.
Yeah, now, you don't have less space. You still have more space, but he has less pieces. So he is now feeling very comfortable. Well, your e5 pawn will soon become a weakness.
Weakness. That's why I just wanted to play f4 at one point, but...
Yeah, bishop e3, you're exchanging more pieces. You have to be careful. Rook e4, knight b3.
Knight
b4. Rook c3. Knight d5. Rook d1. Bishop b7. Okay. Bishop b7, rook c1.
Shouldn't he have played rook c5?
Here?
I didn't feel the rook. Like I felt like the rook.
Trying to double the rooks.
Yeah, possible. Words.
Yeah, but he can just play rook c8.
And then? Bishop d3 and rook d c1.
Why not directly rook?
Yeah.
Takes, then what will you do?
No, then after.
I mean, you have the c file. That's what she's trying to say.
You can play bishop d3 without blocking.
No, but I'm afraid here Trisha of knight f4. Yeah, that's because now I'm threatening bishop into f3.
But then you can play rook c7 now.
Yes, but bishop into f3.
Or you can also play first or one. Why bishop f3 first, rook d1?
No, but you're this is you are a tricky boy. Yeah, okay. Knight e2 check is the threat, and then you mate
it's
me.
Mate. It's mate.
Nice. No, your rook is on c7. Can we do something to stop it? Like, for example, knight d2?
Knight d2.
Oops. If you take on d2, I might take on b7.
Why not first play knight e2 check?
Play h3.
Ah, check, king here.
Now rook d2.
And then I take on b7.
Now h6.
Or g6 maybe.
Yeah,
or
g5.
Hmm. So okay, so basically I think black got, but overall in your position after rook c1 you offered a draw. No, rook c8 a3. But I don't think black should accept the draw here.
He never accepted.
Yeah.
Offered a draw about fourth time was just for fun. I was just queen down.
But why do you offer so many draws?
I know I felt like I was in a very bad position.
Yes, but offering a draw most of the times doesn't solve the purpose because your opponent is not going to take it if he's in a better position. So might as well fight.
Yeah.
You know, draw.
Knight
b4.
No, in general, I think black is better. He can get his king out to e7. He can also start some play on the king side. Knight is coming to f4. So, it was an interesting game, Ritvik. But
a3 is wrong because knight b4, rook into
a3. Why don't you come here for tell people, you can sit here. So, that's everyone. The voice which you are hearing till now was Trisha. You can go here and say hi.
If knight b4 is wrong because of rook into d8, then rook c7 is also free again because the knight was supporting c7.
Yes, but then bishop into
f3 is also there, by
the
way.
No, she's saying don't play a3. Okay. Anyway, so this was a good game. Thanks a lot. I hope you understood what you did wrong.
Yes.
Okay.